Hi, my name is Nate Nordman. I'm a PGY3 with SIU Neurosurgery. We cover both Memorial and Saints. Today we're going to be talking about how to properly insert, place, zero, and monitor with the Camino ICP monitoring system. So first off, just to talk about indications for the ICP monitor. So we like to place these in any patients who are GCS 3 to 8 with an abnormal head CT, whether that be contusion, swelling, epidural hematoma, subdural hematoma, things like that. Or if the patient is GCS 3 to 8 with a normal head CT, but they have two of the following: they are greater than or equal to the age of 40 years old, they have unilateral or bilateral posturing in their extremities, or their systolic blood pressure is less than 90. So there are multiple different things that we like to ask nursing if they have time to grab for us ahead of time, so that way it's all ready to go at the bedside and we can get ready to place this. So we need sterile gloves, we need the ICP monitoring kit, and there's multiple different types of these. The most common one that I see we use is the intraparenchymal ICP monitor. We also use the ventricular Camino, which allows us to monitor pressures and also drain fluid through an EVD at the same time. We'll talk about those in more detail. Cranial access kit, which has our grill to access the skull, and obviously the patient. Other things that we need, which we would like to get ahead of time, is antibiotics. Usually we do 2 grams of ANSEF if the patient's not allergic to that medication, and also lidocaine with epinephrine, either 1% or 2%. It doesn't matter, but just to have that at the bedside too. So next we can talk about the different types of monitors that we have. So this is one that we frequently use, but I would say we use this one a little bit more often. This is the ventricular catheter one. This actually gets inserted into the brain, into the ventricle system. And so we typically insert it right around this area called Coker's point, and that goes straight into the ventricle, allows us to drain fluid and also monitor ICPs at the same time. And just for reference, what we use for Coker's point, it's about 11 centimeters back from the nasion and about 3 centimeters over. So it should be basically in midline with the eye, and that would coordinate to about a centimeter or so right in front of the coronal suture. And so this helps us mark out an important area of the brain that we want to stay a centimeter in front of that. So another one of the ICP monitoring devices that we use is the intraparenchymal monitor. And this basically does not allow you to remove fluid through the ventricular system, but basically gets inserted through the skull right into the brain, just at the tip of the brain into the parenchyma. And we'll demonstrate how to zero this here in a second.
Hi, my name is Emily Nagel. I'm a nurse on the 2C ICU unit, the neuro unit. So I'm just showing you the cables and monitors you need once we place the bolt and are hooking up the Camino. So you'll need the Camino monitor itself and then the power cable to connect it to the wall. The power cable connects to the back. And then you will plug it into the wall. Once it's fully charged, it stays fully charged. And then after you unplug it, you have about an hour and a half life on the battery. Next cable you're gonna need is the black cable that connects to the patient itself. There are two ends to this. One is a temperature end that has a T on it. We don't use that one. The other one has a P on it. This one connects to the side of the monitor here. And then this one will go to the patient once it's connected. So the next cord you'll need is the gray cord. This one connects on the opposite side of the black cord in the back of the monitor here underneath the power cable. Once this cord is connected, you'll connect this, the bigger end, to the short cable that goes to the hemopod itself. This just screws on. The next cord you're going to need is the hemopod itself. This has an orange end that once it's connected to the patient, you will connect these orange to orange together. On the opposite end of the hemopod, you have the cord that connects to the new Drager monitor itself. This one goes into the hemopod port here. Remember that you have to use the quad hemopod for this monitor because the orange connectors will not connect if it's a regular dual hemopod. Once all of your cables are connected besides the patient connection itself, which is the black cord, you will turn on your Camino. Once the monitor is initialized, you will come to the main screen. You can click on the settings button and adjust the waveform to line or fill. You can also change the date and time. There is also a trend button on the Camino. Usually this starts with a scale of negative 10 to 20. If you click the ICP scale, you can change those parameters.
So in sterile fashion, if we're doing the ventricular puncture Camino, we will insert this, and this will allow us to get cerebral spinal fluid out. In either case, if we use this, or if we use the intraparenchymal ICP monitor, the device is taken out, laid sterilely on the field, and it first must be zeroed before going inside of the patient. So in a sterile fashion, I will connect this to that. After the fiber optic cable is connected, it now must be zeroed. And so that is with a little screwdriver. And so right now, it says the ICP is 18, but it needs to be at zero. So this is really finicky. So once this is zeroed, it'll show zero here on the scale. It should match up with the zero on the monitor. And then this is inserted into the brain by the physician at the bedside. After that, it should immediately show an ICP waveform and pressure. Of importance, once inserted, a lot of times we end up getting called for ICPs that are abnormally high or are reading negative. So not on the ventricular puncture catheter, but on the intraparenchymal monitors, this comes with a red dot that lies between the very tip here and this little etched marking of the catheter. And so that red dot should almost always be between there. And a lot of times this ends up getting dislodged, pulled back a little bit, or pushed forward, and that can give abnormal ICPs. So if the ICP monitor seems like it doesn't correlate well with the patient's exam, or is in an abnormally high or negative number, I would say one of the first things to check is whether or not that red dot is within those markings.
For nursing care, once the catheter is placed and all your connections are secured, this black box does have a lot of weight to it. There is a clip where you can secure it to a pillow. Make sure when repositioning the patient, like he said previously, that the catheter is not getting pulled on. Also, these can be disconnected for travels, but remember that the bolts are not MRI safe.
So when reading ICPs off of the Camino, what numbers are appropriate? What numbers are abnormal? So in an adult, the normal ICPs typically range from 5 to 15. With coughing, exertion, moving the patient, ICPs can go high, 30 or so, and then they should immediately fall back down. What we call abnormal or typically like to be called on is when, for example, trauma patients, if the ICPs on the monitor are reading greater than 22 and it's sustained for 5 minutes.